Hey guys, it's Monika. I am going to share with you some of my thoughts on the so-called anti-aging thing, if there is such a thing. Do you think you can anti-age? I don't know. But anyways, this is a tag that was created for the mature beauty community. Actually, anyone can do it, but it's more applicable, I think, to the mature beauty community because many of us in this community are definitely trying to anti-age or at least slow down that aging process. So this tag was created originally by Sarah, the retro anti-ager, and I was actually tagged by Karen Renee Beauty. Now I've seen many, many women do this tag, so I'm sure I would leave someone out if I started to mention them all, so I'm not going to. But where Karen was the last person, or the only person probably, that tagged me, I'm going to link her channel. So I'm going to look down on my iPad to read some of the questions for you. The first one is pretty easy. What is your age group? And, you know, everyone knows I'm in the 60 plus age group. I just turned 64 on February 14th, and I can't believe I'm that old, but I am. So question number two, what bothers you the most about aging? I think what really, really bothers me the most about aging is that as I get older, I will be more dependent on other people to help me out. My kids, or, you know, who knows, maybe even eventually into a healthcare facility or nursing home where I'm going to be dependent on others. And I'm not terribly super independent, at least I never thought I was, but I don't want to depend on anyone to take care of me. And that, I think, bothers me the most. I don't want to be in a position where I can't wipe my own tushy and need someone to do that for me or need someone to help me get dressed or eat. So I think that's what scares me the most, bothers me the most about aging. Have I had any procedures done? I have not had any procedures done. I'm not against it. I'm not in a financial position, you know, to afford a facelift. It isn't covered by my insurance or anything of that nature. I would entertain having fillers. These bother me a lot, my jowly things or whatever they are. They bother me a lot, and maybe someday we'll have a filler or whatever you would call it there. I am very, very interested in zapping out my veins. I have not done that yet. I know a number of my close friend subscribers have done it. They've encouraged me to look into it. And when I go to my dermatologist for my 1 year checkup in the summer, I'm going to explore that as an option because my veins do bother me a lot. So yeah, no, I am, you get what you see. You get what you see. So if not, would you? I think I already answered that. Question number five, what is the pivotal point where you realized you wanted to tackle anti-aging? I really don't think there was a pivotal point. I think even though for the first 60 years of my life, I didn't really think much about anti-aging. I also didn't think much about, you know, skincare in general. I always washed my face. I always removed my makeup. I always used some sort of oils on my skin all my life. I think that might have helped me with the wrinkles a little bit. But I think it wasn't until I was 60 that I became more aware of the age spots and how quickly the wrinkles were happening. So I didn't go on an anti-aging mission as I went on a, I call a sort of on steroids skincare program. And that's what I did. I started to explore how to better take care of the skin I have to maybe preserve it a little bit longer. So do you think it's possible to anti-age? No, come on, not really. I don't think you can anti-age. I do believe you can slow down the aging process and by good skincare and sunblock. But anti-age, no. You know, maybe in the future there'll be a pill you can take that'll bring you back to 16 if you want. But right now, maybe it's in the development process. I don't know, but I don't know that it's there. I don't know that it'll be in my lifetime for sure. Number seven, of all the lotions and potions for anti-aging out there, which ones do you think are a gimmick? I really think probably all of them are, you know, a gimmick of some sorts. I think you might have a product that works a little bit, and then the hype makes it instantaneous. I never trust anything that says, within a week, you're going to see dramatic results. it's just not gonna happen. I really think that you need to try something, and I've said this before, you need to try something for a good long time before you actually see any kind of result at all. So I think most of it is a gimmick. So to me, the tried and true would obviously be the Retin-A. That's the gold standard. That has been tried and true. So even that is not an overnight fix. So there's a lot of awesome products out there, but none of them are gonna be overnight. And if you hear of an overnight, wake up tomorrow and look 20 years younger. Nah, not gonna happen, not gonna happen. Which ones work? I think I already said that. To me, Retin-A works. I am a big believer in vitamin C. I love using a good, high quality vitamin C serum. So there's a lot of face serums that I really like. Vitamin C, Matrixyl. I love the Ordinaries and Buffet. You know, so there's a number of serums that I use that I really like. But my creams, I'm a bee venom lover, so you know, to me that's a tried and true. My Retin-A's a tried and true. I've been using a Olay product around my eyes now for about a month. Again, for me, I wouldn't even say it's a tried and true. I will tell you I'm liking it, but you know, until I go further into it, it's not gonna be something I'm gonna say, you've gotta try. I've also been trying a new eyelash serum, many of you know, Blink, so I've been doing that just about a month now. So I have really strong feelings on what's happening to my eyelashes with this new product. But I also know, for me really to tell how good it is, I need to go another few weeks, a month, or maybe even two, before I go forward with it, or talk about it. Number 9, if you could change just one thing about your aging process, what would it be? Getting fatter. I really think the older I get, the boobs drop. I'll probably get demonetized for saying that. Sorry, YouTube. But everything drops, and you know, your weight fluctuates, waists get thicker. I'm not a thin person, I've never been a thin person. My sister's a thin person, so I inherited the fat genes, she inherited the thin genes. So gaining weight so easily really bothers me about that process a lot. That really disturbs me. Number 10, what one thing are you most pleased with about your physical appearance at this point in your life? Well, I guess I would have to say it's my skin. I am pleased with my skin. I mean, it's not perfect. I have breakouts, I have wrinkles, I have veins. But overall, I think my skin doesn't look my age in general. Or maybe I don't act my age. Maybe it's a combination of all that. I don't know. But I would say my skin I'm the most pleased with. Do you accept that you are getting older? Yeah, well, what's the alternative? Every day I'm happy I wake up, and every day I'm a little bit older. And yeah, I accept it, it's going to happen, and I'm okay with that. I've lived a good life. I still have a lot of living to do, but I have lived a good life. I've loved, I've been loved, I'm blessed. I have been fortunate, I've been misfortunate. I've had a very well-rounded life. I can't complain about that at all. Number 12. When it's all said and done, what is it all about? Is it external or internal? It's internal for sure, without a doubt for me, because I believe in feeding everything, you know, like my collagen supplement from the inside out. So to me, the inside out is what makes the biggest difference. So it is definitely internal for me. Number 13. If you had to choose growing older more rapidly with your physical appearance, yet having vibrant health, or vice versa, outwardly growing slower but declined health, outwardly aging slower, I messed that one up. I would say I would rather have good health, even if it meant aging rapidly. I would rather have good health, because good health will make my life more enjoyable. So I can look young and beautiful but be sick inside, and I'm not going to enjoy it as much. So yeah, I'll take, you know, the rapid aging if that's what it takes, and be in good health for the years I have left, than to be not in good health. Like I said earlier, my biggest fear is being dependent on someone. I don't want to ever get to that point. I don't know, you know, those are the answers to my questions. I don't know how many of you have done this CAG. I think it's very interesting. again, I do not necessarily believe in the phrase anti-aging, although I do use it in my videos. I use it as a tag because I know it's a searchable term. But it to me has always been all about the inside out. So I hope you enjoyed my answers, and thank you so much for the tag, Karen and Sarah, for making up the tag. It was a lot of fun. I enjoyed watching everyone's videos. And if you're new to my channel, please subscribe and welcome. And for all of you that watch all my videos, huge, huge hugs to you all. Thank you. Bye, guys.